It's a thing. It's a new thing that I just thought of, and it's gonna work out just fine. I was away for their wedding. They got married in Brazil. It sounded like fun. There was no alcohol at that kind of wedding because it was a very serious wedding and no fun allowed either. I'm very sorry I missed it, but thank you guys for coming out. The guy behind me, this is James. Chris calls him the secret weapon. If you're hearing what he's playing on guitar, you understand why he calls him the secret weapon. He's been the most consistent part of the music I've made in the last 5-6 years. Insanely talented. I don't know why he keeps showing up to practices and recordings and all this kind of stuff. I have not figured it out. I'd like to go, like, you know, I'm used to playing music with, like, Chris, and we try really hard, but we don't necessarily sound like that. And it's, Chris is really good at bass, but he's just, you know, he's not necessarily James on guitar.
That's very true.
And Tamara, thank you for coming out this evening as well. Everybody else, I'm trying to see more. We're gonna do one more song together. I'm gonna do one more song alone after that. And that's gonna be it. Sarah, there's a secret message in this song for you. It's a secret song. Is this place not Sarah Prophet style? Super Sarah Prophet style. Sarah's fancy. This is our last song together. Thank you guys very much. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you on behalf of Covenant House. I have never done a benefit for something that I did not believe in, or something where I did not hand deliver the money to the place myself, whether it's a school I was working with, or an organization, whatever it is. I was very happy that my aunt could make it out this evening. Often we donate money, we don't necessarily know what it goes to, but it's going to an unbelievable cause. And not to sound too cheesy, but it's just truly, truly, truly amazing to be surrounded by such talent. More than that, such good people. Not everybody has that opportunity. So when you go home from this tonight, maybe just think twice, that you don't have to rely on living in a shelter or something else, but that you did something for the people that do need to rely on that. I think usually there's at least 300 or so kids in New York on a daily basis that benefit from what Covenant House does. So there's 300 kids that are getting some services tonight as a result of what you guys are doing. So thank you again for coming out and listening to this. We're gonna do one more song together.
Song just from hearing that, so I can imagine that. One, two, one, two.
In all good faith and sentiment, I can't believe somehow that I haven't died of grief or something since you left this town. I'm all undecorated, cigarettes, standard white apartment wall, and 3 a.m. and 4 a.m. It's impossible to sleep. I'm all sore eyes, there's beasts at my back door, pulling out their claws. And yes, I will take those, whatever else they give me. If it stops the nightmares, man, it probably won't kill me. And if I slow it down, I'd fall upon accuser's knives. Yeah, I'd only stop and tell her that I love her at the red lights. Too much to lose yourself. Sometimes you just can't get there back. And you may be an angel or a devil, I don't know. And if in fact you are now love, well, I've been there before. Yeah, I've fallen on my face and I've been burned so near to death, I probably won't live through it anyhow. And yes, I will take those, whatever else they give me. If it stops the nightmares, then it probably won't kill me. And if I slow it down, I fall upon accuser's knives. Yeah, I'd only stop and tell her that I love her at the red lights. Thank you. slow it down, I phone the phone, accuser's knife. Yeah, I'd only stop and tell her that I love her at the red lights. Thank you, guys. Hold on 1 second before you leave the stage. Just give me 1 second. Teresa, can you help me out? Very honestly, if you heard what Grace and Leah were doing.
That's really good. That is clap. That's clap. That's for how bad of a person I am. Yeah. Thank you guys. Give them a round of applause.
I'm just going to do one more, and that's it.
Well done, baby.
So I got to meet this one person in my life. It was unexpected. But like I said, she opened the doors to her home for me. And since then, she ends up getting her doctorate. She's doing her doctorate at Rutgers right now. Immensely proud of the steps she's taken to do what's right for her, to build her life for herself. She also ran this organization in Namibia where I work called Physically Active Youth, called PAY. It has made a tremendous difference in the lives of many, 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 many students. And she has a TED Talk about it, actually, where she talks about it. You can look her up, Marijan. I'm not good at pronouncing your last name, Marijan. I apologize. But,
MJ,
exactly, MJ. But she came here to do her doctorate. She recently, she met a very nice gentleman. His name is Michael. He's in the back over there. And I think it's truly a story that's a testament to, like, sometimes you just have to pick up and go and you don't know all the reasons, but you gotta get out of a situation that's not doing you any good. You gotta have some faith that the next situation's gonna do you a little bit better, and it's done her wonderful things. And I went out to go visit her in Newark last Thursday night, and we had a talk, and we have a lot of heart-to-hearts. And it's amazing, it's just amazing to be able to travel around the world and to see, you meet people of such different cultures, people who have had such different experiences, but at the same time, there's this universal human element of some of the things that we feel and experience and all that. And the only reason that I do this, that I say that, is because a lot of these songs, most of these songs were written in different places that I lived. So I get to carry them back here to New York and share them with you. So like I said, your attention means a lot to me, and I get to have them made sound so much better by the people I play with. But playing them for me is just pure catharsis. It's just an unbelievable thing to share. Getting back to what I said, Marijan, thank you for coming out this evening. Michael, you have a very, very absolutely wonderful woman that you're with. Killer, thank you for coming out as well. It really means a lot to me. Anyone that I missed, like I said, it's a bit dark. Lauren, Ezra, Tim, Sarah, everybody, to my aunt, to my three sisters over there. One of the best nights of my life. I love sharing this stuff with you guys. It really means a lot to me, and it means a lot to have done it for a good cause. When I moved to Japan, I think Chris could testify to this. I just don't think... I wasn't as good at playing music. I came back from Japan.
Much better.
Yeah. So I came back from Japan and I got to have these unbelievable experiences, one of which my mother and my sister Kelly got to see, you know, tons of people. We did a benefit show for our friend Rob McAllister, who passed away and was a record release. You can give him a round of applause. He was the best human being. There was a record release for some songs that I recorded there, and we had a little over 100 people or something come out, and I was stressed. I probably ruined the whole week that they came to visit. I was yelling about stuff and being mad about stuff because I had to pay for the venue if nobody showed up to the show. But luckily, a whole bunch of people showed up, just like you guys did tonight. So thank you, guys. It's truly, truly amazing to share the experiences that inspired these songs, kind of through these songs, with all of you. This goes out to one person, my favorite person in Japan. Her name is Aiko as well. I just went back to Japan in June to visit some friends from the music scene there and to record some music. And this goes out to Asako. Mostly it goes out to Aiko. The song is called Daydream. It's the last song I'm going to play tonight. So thank you guys for listening and hang out for a little bit after. I think we're going to go to a bar nearby. So thank you, guys. writing these songs to feel better, as an umbrella for inclement weather. And then the next thing I knew, they were all about you. I started writing these songs to heal wounds, to get over what ended too soon. And then the back and the forth, the pain and the cost, the price that we pay, there's a hurt, there's a loss, and a heart that got split in two. And it was all over you. This is about how I wish I could change, how what's wrong with me would go away, so we could reside in a place somewhere quiet and safe, a nondescript town somewhere out of the way, where I'd settle my heart and my jangling nerves, and I'd be the man that I know you deserve, and I'd stop making decisions on baseless ambitions. I'd quiet the thoughts against what I'm taught, and I'd write my songs for your planning lessons. You're shaping the minds, teens and adolescents. When I started having thoughts like this, that's when I knew they were all about you. Cause you're the place that I go when I hide, you're the one that I trust when I'm talking too much. You're an angel, a queen, and I'm caught in between what I want and what I'm destined to be. Now you're the songs that I write, my reason to get better, the words that I sing, as if I'm reading letters. Every syllable's a bandage for wounds, and each one's about you. Between responsibilities, I'd walk along these sidewalks and think of possibilities for you and me. And this was my daydream, and I'm sleepwalking through these streets. Thank you guys very much for coming out tonight. We're gonna have my amp. Oh, I brought some CDs. The internet hasn't been invented, right? It's 2017. Peggy, if you want to come up, you can.
No.
She's gonna speak from back there.
The beauty of this night is largely engendered by a person who in Africa and Asia and Latin America and Venezuela, all these places, has gone to be a builder and a musician and a teacher and so many other things. And I just really want to say, apart from all the talent that we saw tonight, this is the great gift, Frankie, that you've brought to the world. And I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud, and I'm thrilled to meet all of you who we've talked about for so long. So thank you again for coming. The applause for you and for
the guy that's on next has won a Grammy, so I'm gonna move all my stuff off the stage. He literally won a Grammy. I looked it up last night. I was like, all right, who's up after me? I'm like, oh, you won a Grammy. Okay.
One day, Frank.
Yeah, we're getting there.
One day, Frank. More instruments.
Yeah, more instruments.
Where are your CDs, Frank?
Oh, we got some over here.
You'll be outside.
Oh, you're all
be outside. You'll be outside after the show.
I got CDs and some merch sneakers that fell off the back of the truck.
Yeah. Come on, take them all together.
Samara, could you take a picture? Grace.
Yes. Yes. Let me take a picture. Yeah. Hey, how are you? Hey,
I don't know.